Hey everyone, welcome back to Capsa. Today we are diving into appendicitis, a painful, potentially life-threatening condition. In this video, we will explore its causes, symptoms, treatment options, and even look at the natural remedies and exercises for prevention. Plus, I will explain when it's time to see a doctor. Stay tuned till the end of your useful tips. Let's dive into the causes of appendicitis. The most common cause or reason is blockage in the appendix, often caused by hardened stool, sometimes called fecalith, or even a foreign body or tumor. This blockage leads to increased pressure, decreased blood flow, and inflammation. Another major cause is infection, gastrointestinal infections, whether viral, bacterial, or parasitic, can irritate the appendix. In some cases, swelling of the lymphatic tissues due to viral infections can also lead to a blockage. There is also evidence suggesting a genetic link, meaning if a close relative has had appendicitis, you might be at higher risk. Finally, a low fiber diet may increase the changes of blockage by promoting constipation. Keep in mind, while these are the common causes, appendicitis can happen unpredictably. Now, how do you know if you have appendicitis? The most common symptom is a sharp pain in the lower right abdomen. You may feel nausea, vomiting, and also loss of appetite. Some patients may have fever, chills, and even constipation or diarrhea. If these symptoms worsen, it's crucial to seek medical attention. So, when should you actually visit a doctor? If you experience sudden severe abdominal pain, or if the pain begins around your navel and moves to the lower right side, that's a red flag. If these symptoms come with a higher fever, or you are unable to pass gas or have bowel movements, you should head to the emergency room immediately. When it comes to managing appendicitis, the main treatment is appendectomy, or the surgical removal of the appendix. Surgeons often use a minimally invasive procedure called laparoscopic surgery, which allows for quicker recovery. In more severe cases, like if the appendix has ruptured, open surgery may be necessary, which involves a longer recovery time. In early cases, some patients may receive antibiotics to treat infections and reduce inflammations. But this approach is not a permanent solution. In many cases, surgery will still be required at a later stage. After surgery, it's important to focus on rest and proper hydration. Gradually transition back to a normal diet, starting with bland, low-fiber foods and slowly introducing more fiber to prevent constipation. Also, keep an eye on your surgical site to catch any signs of infection, like swelling or redness. If you notice any concerning symptoms, contact to your healthcare provider immediately. Though appendicitis typically required medical interventions, certain natural remedies can support recovery and overall digestive health. A high fiber diet consisting of whole grains, fruits, vegetables may help prevent digestive blockages that contribute to appendicitis. Staying hydrated is also key to maintaining a healthy digestive tract. You can incorporate natural anti-inflammatory foods such as ginger and turmeric, which are known to reduce inflammation, and garlic, which boosts the immune system. Omega-3 rich foods like fish and flax seeds may further reduce inflammation and support your body's recovery. After surgery, physical activity should be minimal. At first, starting with high walking or light walking to improve circulation and prevent blood clots. After about 2 weeks, patients can gradually increase activity, though heavy lifting and strenuous exercises should be avoided. Simple breathing exercises can also help improve lung capacity and prevent any respiratory issues that might arise during your recovery. Diagnosing appendicitis typically begins with a physical exam. Doctors will press on the abdomen, especially on McBurney's point, the area located in the lower right abdomen. A classic sign of appendicitis is rebound tenderness, where pain worsens upon the release of pressure. To confirm the diagnosis, doctors may order blood tests to check for the elevated white blood cells count, indicating an infection, as well as C-reactive protein or CRP levels to assess the inflammation. Imaging tests are crucial for definitive diagnosis. An ultrasound is often the first step, as it's non-invasive and can help identify an inflamed appendix. In more complex cases, especially when a rupture is suspected, a CT scan provides a clearer image. For pregnant women or individuals where radiation exposure should be avoided, MRI may be used. So to sum up, appendicitis can be life-threatening if untreated, so it's important to recognize the symptoms as early as possible. Treatment is straightforward, and with surgery and with the right care, recovery can be smooth. Make sure to listen to your body and seek help if you experience any of these symptoms. Drop any questions in the comments and I will be sure to answer them. Stay healthy. Thank you.